In this video, we'll demonstrate automatic configuration of ThinOS clients using Wyse Management Suite On-Premise with DHCP option tags. There are three steps in this video. In the first step, we will configure the DHCP user-defined tags to configure Wyse Thin clients automatically. In the second step, we add the required files to the inventory and configure global level policy. In the last step, we will configure an app policy to add the required packages to the Thin client. Now, let's set up the DHCP user-defined option tags to configure Wyse ThinOS clients automatically. We will define the option tag 165 for WMS server, option tag 167 for CA validation, and option tag 199 for group token. To register devices using DHCP option tags, open the server manager and go to Tools. Click the DHCP option, right-click IPv4, and then click Set Predefined Options. In the new window, from the option class drop-down list, select DHCP standard option and click Add. Configure the DHCP option tags. Use the values shown on the screen for Wyse Management Suite URL, CA Validation Server URL, and group token. Right-click Scope Options and configure the newly added option tags. On the client side, restart the Thin client. Select Reset the system settings to factory default. At this point, the Thin client is now registered. Now that the Thin client is registered, let's configure the default group policy. This is step 2. Log in to the Wyse Management console. Go to Devices tab and see the Thin client is added to the default policy group. To add the ThinOS firmware, go to Apps and Data and under OS Image Repository, click ThinOS. Click Add Firmware File. To select a file, click Browse and navigate to the location where your file is located. Enter the description for your file and click Upload. You can download the ThinOS firmware from dell.com/support. To add wallpaper, go to File Repository, click Inventory, and then click Add File. On the Add File page, click Browse to select the wallpaper. Select the type as wallpaper. Enter the required description in the description field and click Upload. Likewise, you can add the certificate by repeating the same steps. The wallpaper and certificates are now added to the inventory. You can also add logos and other files in the file repository. Now, let's add the rtme.i86 ThinOS package files to the Thin Client Apps directory to configure the group policy in step 3. On the local repository, go to the Thin Client Apps folder and place the rtme.i86 package file. Go to Portal Administration and click Sync Files to ensure that the application is registered. Or you can wait for up to a minute for the package files to sync automatically. Now, to configure the global level policy, click Groups and Configs on the dashboard. Click Edit Policies and select ThinOS. Select Wizard Mode on the ThinOS Configuration Mode window. In this video, the settings used are not mandatory. You can also modify the settings to fit your environment. Now, on the Setup Security page, check Auto Install Certificates and select the file which you uploaded. Enter the VNC password and click Next. Keep the default settings under Setup Keyboard and Display. In the Setup Visual Experience tab, enable the desktop wallpaper and select the file which you uploaded under Desktop Appearance. Under Visual Experience for security reasons, select Sign Off Automatically for actions after all sessions exit. Next, set up the time zone in the Setup Time Zone page. Provide the domain name and select the ThinOS firmware under Select General Settings. Set up the broker in the Setup Broker section. For this demo, we use Citrix, but you can pick the broker that fits your environment from the drop-down list, and provide the broker server URL. You can add a custom store name if you use one, but this is not mandatory. And finally, click Save and Publish. On the client side, the policy changes are applied. Now, in step 3, let's create an app policy to deploy the rtme.id6 package file. In Apps and Data, go to App Policies and click Thin Client. Click Add Policy and enter the policy name. From the drop-down list, select the group and OS type and then click Save. On the alert window, click Yes to schedule the job. On the App Policy Job window, select the policy name, provide the description, and select Immediately. Then click Preview. On the preview page, click Schedule. At this point, the job is now scheduled, and you can see the rtme.id6 package being deployed on the client side. The jobs can be scheduled as per your requirement. This brings us to the end of the video. To summarize, we've learned how to configure the ThinOS client using DHCP option tags, add files to Wyse Management Suite inventory, configure the global level policy, and deploy the application policy to the Thin Client using Wyse Management Suite. For more information, see the Wyse Management Suite documents at dell.com/support.